Okay, let's look at lecture one. And in this lecture, we're going to take a look at scale factor, how to determine that, title blocks. We're going to also take a look at some attributes, the design center, and how to actually create a block. First thing we're going to start with is the scale factor. Scale factor is probably one of the most important things you're going to use in this program, and it's going to be the basis for everything that you're going to need to create around that drawing. So you're going to create a drawing, and then all your text height, dimensions, liters, and scale factor will be based off of that. And I'm just going to show you how to calculate that. So when we're first determining what the scale factor should be, we're going to draw the drawing according to the dimensions that we have. Then we're going to insert a title block. And also remember that your lower left-hand corner should always be at 0, 0. Once you select your title block, then you're going to wind up adjusting your title block around your drawing to see what size it actually fits around it. And then we'll sit on a drawing inside of it. So once we figure out the size of our drawing, that's going to be our scale factor, and we're going to use some things to determine. That's going to be used as your base point to determine everything else you're going to need. Okay, some of the ways we're going to calculate the scale factor is just, for example, here's a quick little one. If you have a drawing and it says that it's 3/16 equals a foot, you can see that after you go through all the mathematical computations that you will come out with, the scale factor of that drawing is going to be 64. If you're using metric units, they work a little bit simpler. Basically, most of the time it's going to be the number on the right hand side if the number on the left hand side is 1. So if you have a drawing that's set to 1 to 100, the scale factor should be 100. Okay, let's take a look at the title block now. First, when you're building a title block, the outside of it that represents the paper is going to be the border of it. So the outside of your title block will be the border or the frame that's going around it. And you can see on both of these different drawings, it's nothing more than the rectangle that's representing the paper. You have different border sizes of it in the industry, and usually you start off with an A size, and that's nothing more than your letter size piece of paper. And then you can calculate how to get down to the B size. Typically, we're going to carry the higher number, and then we'll double the lower number. And that step is just going to continue for each process of it, depending on what size paper that you're trying to create. So if you have a B size, D size, all the way up to an E size, and if you have paper sizes beyond that, you can calculate it just by using these steps. If we're looking at an architectural border, we're going to do the exact same thing. We're going to start off with a 9 by 12. We're going to keep the bigger number, and we're going to double a small number. So according to everything else, the border sizes are going to look exactly like the following here, all the way down to an E size. And of course, if we need to calculate an F, we can do that. The metric scale, their border size work a little bit backwards. Their A0 is actually more or less their big size, and then you have an A1, and they do the exact same thing except for they work a little bit backwards. They take the smaller number and then they cut the bigger number in half. So if you come all the way down to an A4 is where they start off with an A size. So if you're working in millimeters, an A4 is going to be your A size. All the way up to your A1 is your D, and your A0 is going to be your E size. The border zones, you may see some drawings with them or without them. They're just nothing more than a quick reference to help you locate something. So if somebody says that, hey, we have a problem in zone C3, you have a general quick mapping area to get to there. If you remember that the ANSI standards are going to use the third angle projection, and ISO standards always use the first angle projections. So we're in America here in the United States, and we're going to use the third angle projection. International typically will use your first angle projection. Text and attributes. So now when you're building a text style, you're going to see a dialog box that appear like so. And I would highly recommend that you always keep your height set to 0. If you change this height, then it's going to be a permanent fix. And when you're doing any kind of other things like dimensions or liters or anything else that's using this text style, it's going to always be stuck at that height. So I always recommend that everyone leave that to 0. You also have two types of text in this program. You're going to have dynamic text and you're going to have multi-line text. Dynamic text is going to be also referred to as nothing more than single line text. And as we do that, you're going to have to know that you're going to have to hit each character and things of that nature. One of the most important things when you're using dynamic text is that you do not, when you're finished with typing out your line, you do not want to hit the escape button. You always want to hit the enter button first and then hit the escape. With the multi-line text, it kind of works more like a word processor. So you're going to have a close button that's going to be at the top. And if I'm not mistaken, if you hit the escape button, it's going to always ask you, do you want to save your changes? So it has a fail-safe built into it. The justification. So just to remember what justification or how do you want to control your text is the kind of the way that you're thinking about this. So anytime you're creating a text, you have different justifications of it. So if you want to control it by the right or the bottom left or different kind of options, it will create these nodes or these little dots in those areas that you can control and move by. The bottom here tells me that if I'm using that same 64 scale again and I want my text height to be 0.125 or an eighth of an inch, you multiply those two together so your text height for that drawing will be a height of 8. The edit text command is used just to edit the text. You can easily double click on a text if you don't have any command activated, and that will also put you in the edit text command, or you can type in ed enter and you can edit the text. Next thing you want to do is if we want to create some attributes, and we're going to do this on our title block. So one of our examples is going to deal with actually creating these attributes. And attributes is nothing more than a block, and it has some embedded text added into it. And that embedded text, you can change it, or it'll ask you, do you want to change it? And you can do different things of it, depending on what type of mode that you put it in. Here's some of the details of that attribute dialog box. So you can see that the top left box controls the behavior of it. The bottom left will control where you want to place it. The prompts are going to be your top right. And at the bottom right, it's going to deal with what kind of text and how you want to control that text. The different modes that you're going to see when you're doing attributes is you're going to have your invisible, constant, variable, preset, lock position, and multi-lines. So depending on what kind of you want this text to behave or how you want your attributes to behave, you'll pick the according mode, and that will correlate to what you want. And remember, you can pick multiple ones of these as well. Once you get to the user interface, you're going to have a tag, a prompt, and a default. The tag is nothing more than a basic computer language of how you want the attribute to look. The prompt is what you want the computer to ask you in a dialog box. And the default is if you have something that you want to always put in that, you can have that in your default. Here are some attribute commands that you're going to use just to change or modify or edit some of these attributes. Okay, next let's talk about blocks. Blocks is nothing more than a collection of a lot of your objects that you've drawn, and it'll create them and keep them as one. You're going to have two different types of ways of storing them. Basically, you can store one that's attached to your file that you're drawing your AutoCAD to, or you can make that a separate file that you can go out and access to, and maybe everybody else can access to it. So the one that's embedded into your drawing is going to be the block command, and the one that's going to be edited outside, it's going to be the W block. And if you notice up here, you're going to have the W block. It has a little disk next to it. So that's kind of how your signal for knowing that it's actually belongs somewhere else. You got some alternate block methods of doing it. So if you don't want to use the block command, you can do a copy and paste. And these are the Microsoft. Just a control X, control V's, and your control C's. So you can use any one of those to go ahead and copy, and then you can paste it in as a block. You'll have to use the rename command if you want to rename that block something else. But notice that this will only create the block. It's not going to create you a W block. The Design Center is one of those things that you can use to go and get stuff or extract things out of other drawings. So if I have a drawing that has a lot of blocks in it, I don't have to necessarily open that drawing or recreate that block. I can go to that drawing if I know where it's at by going through the design center, and I can take some of the things out of it. And you can see, according to here, you can see all the things that you could take out of it. You could take some of the blocks, you could take the dimension styles, layers, multi-liter style. So you could grab a lot of different things out of that drawing if you want to borrow it from that drawing.